Yo, it's Thursday, March 28th. I have Jordan Cox in the studio today. We're heading into our fifth Friday and fifth Saturday of the month, but today we're going to talk about a couple of really unique Asotocon sessions and some AI video generation and some saying goodbye to diesels in passenger vehicles from Volvo. A bunch of stuff. Fisker did a thing too. Jordan, what's up today, man?
Happy Thursday, Paul.
Happy Thursday. What am I hearing? Oh, where is that? Where's that coming from? Is that you? It's weird. I don't know who triggered that. I'm like frantically looking at my trigger pad, but that is definitely your walk-on music if I've ever heard it. Who's in the house? JC, things are going well. Things are going well. Yesterday, we made a couple things happened yesterday. Number one, we released More Than Cars episode 3. We released it at 1 o'clock, LinkedIn, had a bunch of people show up to watch it live and in the comments, but now it is out into the world. So you can watch it by going to morethancars.tv. You can go to our YouTube channel, which so cleverly is Asotube, ASOTU.BE. And we were hanging out with the West Her Auto Group. And I've seen that a couple times and I still get teary when I watch it.
It's great storytelling. I got to tell you, great. It's so cool to share that with the world.
My wife was in, we had lunch. She came into the office. And so she was here right when the premiere happened. So we just sat at my desk and watched it. And the part where there's a reveal of one of the characters, you find out who he actually is in the story and like what he means in the dealership. She was like, whoa. So you have to watch it to see if you didn't see it.
You're like, that's him.
that's the one. Hey, we really want to talk about the Asotocon session agenda. Everybody's been waiting for it, asking for it. We know that if you're coming to the event or making the decision to come to an event, or if you're trying to convince your boss to let you go to the event, he wants to know or she wants to know one thing, and that is, what are you going to learn? How is it going to improve our business? I appreciate going to events and having fun with your friends, but I'm not paying you to do that. I'm paying you to bring value back to this dealership. We understand that. So you know, we very carefully curate the sessions for this, which is why it takes us a little bit longer, because there's no like just throw some people on a stage together and ask them questions. We painstakingly go through the chemistry of the different people, what they're good at, what they're not good at, and we put together very unique panels. So I'm going to read some of them. They're all live now, or like 80, 90% of them are live now at asotocon.com. You can click on agenda and click and see the agenda by stage, by day. And if you scroll through the speakers, I was scrolling through the speakers, Jordan, and I was like, I can't believe all these people are going to be in one place.
We get all these people one place, and man, it's just great to have them on stage, but also like connect with them afterwards. That's what's so great about Asotocon is there's so much that can happen between sessions, before it starts, after it ends, go to dinner with someone and just have a great conversation with them.
Really is. We start a lot of conversations on the stage. They carry on into the rest of the event. We have over 50 speakers now live on the site. So you can go see who they are. Lots of dealers, big dealerships, small dealerships, public groups, industry partners, people that you see on the internet all the time that if you want to meet them in person, this is the place to do it. We're going to have a bunch of next gen dealers on the main stage. Kayla Cody, Ronnie Lowenfield, Andy Gwelcher, talk about how the next gen dealers are thriving by putting people first. We have a bunch of ATAs, auto dealer associations on stage from Virginia, Maryland. We're going to have Mike Stanton there from NADA talking about the latest and what's going on. We're going to have three M&A firms on stage at once to talk about some insights. We're going to have represented Presidio Group, Hague Partners, Kerrigan. Everybody's going to be there, and some other sessions I want to, how to deploy brand strategy from marketing to the front lines. We're going to have our man, Duran Cage, Kimberly Barta from Group One. Subi Ghosh is on that panel. Real-time strategies for fixed ops hiring and training. Do you need to hire some people in fixed ops these days? Is that getting difficult? We're actually going to have Dan Schein, the fixed ops editor of Automotive News, moderating that panel with Liza Borsches, Patrice Banks from Girls Auto Clinic there. How about this one? How to maximize profits by providing an amazing employee and customer experience. We have some real savvy operators, Katie Mayers, Phil Gill, Jonathan Dawson, talking about those things. How to build a profitable mobile service division. Ed Roberts, mobile service director. He's got a fixed ops service director and a mobile service director.
And mobile, yeah.
Yeah, so Jeremy Stevens is going to be there. They're trying to build their fleet up to like 50 vehicles. So if you want to get into mobile service, or you have it and aren't good at it, or you want to grow it, this is the place to be. Talking about how to time the EV pivot for your specific market. Big conversation. how to build marketing audiences with more cookies disappearing every day. Gonna have some just absolute killers on that panel. Nathan Hollenbeck, Steve White from Clairvoy, David Spizak will be monitoring it. So literally that was only like a little fraction of the things going on, but so many great practical sessions that you can say to your boss, like, I'm bringing this back. I need to go to the session, learn these secrets, bring them back to our store so we can deploy. There's one that's going to be a little bit of a throwdown. Sales models on trial, single point of contact versus traditional.
Yeah.
We got Scott Simons and Glenn Lundy. We got Michael Wood and Erica Tiffany, who are single point of contact. It's going to be great. So look, go to asotacon.com, get your tickets. The hotel is getting very close to booked, like the main hotel. The other hotels are fine too, but if you want to be in the venue at the time, I think it's only like $179 a night or something. We negotiated a stupid deal. So go to asotacon.com, get your tickets. We need you to be there with us. It's going to be unbelievable. All right. That'd
be great.
I wanted to talk about all that, but now we got to talk about some news.
Yeah. Getting the news.
All right. After 45 years and almost 9 million diesel vehicles produced, Volvo is bidding farewell to diesels in passenger cars, a powertrain that once made up half of its global sales between 2012 and 2016. So the final diesel model, the final diesel vehicle, an XC90 SUV, has rolled off the production line in Torslanda, Sweden, and is going right off the assembly line right into the World of Volvo Museum as a relic from the past. Isn't that so funny? With the factory transition to EV, electric motor production. So they're going, you know, they've stated this very cleanly, that they're going to be all electric brand by 2030. Former CEO Håkan Samuelsson. How do you say his first name?
That's a good guess.
It's got that A with the little circle over it. I don't know how to read that. I am sorry, Mr. Samuelsson. He highlighted the shift away from diesel towards EVs as a commitment to invest in the future electric amidst the declining diesel market in Europe. Now, like, diesel never really caught on in passenger vehicles in the US, but it's a really big deal in Europe.
Yeah, for sure. Actually, you probably don't even know this. Did you know that I drive a diesel sedan?
I did not. It's a Volkswagen.
Yeah, I do. I've had one for 7 years.
What is it, a Passat?
A Jetta.
A Jetta?
Yeah.
I mean, everyone I know that has a diesel Jetta or Passat loves it to death.
Yeah. It's just been such like a big thing, a part of Volkswagen as a whole, having the diesel side of it. And it's been, for me, it's been great. You get 45 miles per gallon. Now, that was back, so it's a 2015. It's an older model. It's the last model year that they did that. But having the ability to get the higher mileage back then was a huge deal. I mean, now you get that with a hybrid, right?
Yeah. Yeah, right. There was nothing even close to that.
Yeah.
Nothing even close to that. Well, I mean, I guess things are transitioning, and this is kind of a big thing. Imagine I'm sure there's a lot of motion around that last one rolling off the line, and all the people that made those diesel engines are now making electric motors, I guess.
That's right. Look at that.
Speaking of electric vehicles.
Stop. Yeah, it's segue.
This one's been a roller coaster. Fisker is making a daring move to slash prices on all its 2023 Ocean models in an effort to boost sales and attract more customers to its electric vehicles. So here's what's happening. They reduced the MSRP of its Ocean Extreme. So this is the vehicle we've seen. This is the one Marques Brown Lee reviewed. A lot of the talk and controversy around it. They've reduced the price on this Extreme trim by almost 40%. So this vehicle just last week was $61,499. Today, it is $37,499. Looking to make it a more attractive thing. So across the board, they're reducing prices from the other trims as well. But basically, they're having tons of financial challenges. They're trying to avoid bankruptcy. They're having talks with a major automaker, which have been kind of falling apart, about some kind of like major stock purchase or acquisition. And they're trying not to trigger any new debt defaults. The New York Stock Exchange has delisted the stock because it has gotten so low. And so they're trying to move some inventory, it looks like, to raise some cash.
It's interesting when they drop the price that much. I mean, Tesla did that too. But think of what that does to the
used car
market.
They dropped it that much, though. How much did Tesla drop?
Tesla did not do that
much. Not even close. No.
Theirs was, what, I think 10 to 12% on some of the higher trim ones.
Yeah, and the higher
on these. It was like 10 grand.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, they made more drastic cuts on like some of the like the Model X, some of the stuff that was over like it was like 117 new, and they brought down like 98. But it still doesn't feel the same when it's like a vehicle that's that expensive.
Exactly.
But I don't know.
Overnight, you change the used car market like that. Just like that. It's nuts.
I wonder what, you know, it'd be interesting to know how many used Fisker Ocean Extremes there are out there. probably not many. But did you see the review by Marques Brownlee on Autofocus? Yeah. And when I said, all I could think about are the dealers who are signed up to be Fisker dealers. And like, I still think they, a partnership with a major automaker would be great. I hope they pull out of this. I love that they adopted a dealer model. They did make a pretty car, and some of the materials and some new ideas they had in there seemed like really great, especially the solar panels like built into the roof of the car. That seems like a very practical addition.
Looked prettier.
one of the issues they had, Marques Brownlee had in his review, is that you couldn't tell what it was actually generating. He said it's got these solar panels. He said, but oddly, there's nowhere in the interface that I can see what that's actually doing for me.
What it's doing for you.
Yeah. Right. Which feels like
it does.
Oh, does it?
Yeah, on the Prius it does. You can see the regeneration just from the solar panel.
Ah, see. Yeah. So, yeah. I mean, we're going to keep watching and see what happens. We really are pulling for Team Fisker and hoping that they're able to figure it out and pull out. Look, if Carvana can pull out what it pulled out of last year.
Yeah, that's true.
I think Fisker can pull it off. They have a lot of smart people. And they do have a product that seems really good. It does seem like it needs a little bit of refinement, but a lot of that refinement seems like it could be software too, so.
Yeah. Well, even if they get acquired by a manufacturer like Nissan or a different manufacturer, they're not going to, I don't think they're going to do it for the brand. I think they're going to do it for the technology.
Yeah, that'll be it. Yeah, right. Like, what does the Fisker brand, like, does it have any, like, brand equity at this point? Well, exactly. It's tough because the brand equity that's building up right now in the last, 30, 60 days hasn't been good brand equity. So, I don't know. I don't know. I mean, we'll figure out what happens and talk about what they can put together. Speaking of putting things together.
Stop. There you go. Segway.
This is going to be a fun one. Hey, if you're not watching, you're going to have to come back and watch this episode because we're going to be talking about some video content. Sora, which is actually OpenAI, the creator of ChatGPT, their new AI video generator has swiftly become a focal point in AI generated content creation, showcasing the vast potential of video content creation from AI. They released a little bit of its capabilities like a few weeks ago, where you see these puppies playing in the snow and it's like, this was all AI generated.
Yeah.
And so basically they gave, now for the first time, they've given access to the software to be prompted to some professional filmmakers, some professional creators, including directors, musicians. And they said, let's see what they can make with the tool, right? So this is more than just like, show me puppies playing in the snow, right? Like that's the kind of a low hanging fruit right there. Everyone wants to see puppies playing in the snow. Some of these videos show some surrealistic scenes like robots dancing, this weird meteor thing will show it. People have concerns about this level of video production because of ethical concerns, right? Like, can you create video content of things that would be unethical, representing other people, representing things that didn't really happen, and trying to convince Exactly. people that the videos are real? One of the filmmakers, Phil Trillo, he said, when you're not replicating the old, but bringing to life the new and impossible ideas, that's when Sora becomes most powerful. So
that's right.
Want to watch some videos, Jordan?
Let's do it.
All right, let's roll. We have two to share with you. First one, let's share the one about the fake soda brand. So we're going to roll the video. We'll explain to you what we're seeing.
How do you explain that?
What you're seeing is a bunch of, very cinematic scenes, man and woman in a restaurant, nostalgic bike shop. Now we're in the water where what looks like a Porsche/McLaren comes out of the water. We're seeing a sneaker. We're seeing a can of soda that says salt soda in the middle of what looks like the salt flats. But it's just like a very, it's a very cinematic piece that is supposed to, I think, evoke an emotion of a brand. Yeah. I don't know. What's your take from that one, Jordan?
I don't know. It was very montagey, right? It's like there's a lot of different scenes that aren't really directly connected, but just like you said, it's trying to get a certain emotion out of that. And I think it's nostalgia is what they were going for, other than the car submarine. Everything else seemed to be very nostalgic.
That's it. And that one I felt it looked great. If you looked at the footage, there's nothing, like a lot of it looked like absolutely real footage, real people We didn't see anyone with seven fingers, you know, no yeah. weird Will Smith chewing pasta, right? We weren't there at all. Right. But one of the things, the cohesive elements of that video that held it together was definitely the track, the piano music. Now, all of these videos that you're seeing were generated by AI, the track, the music, and this next one, the script and the storyboard, were obviously created by the filmmaker, and they used AI to generate the images. And one of the key components of Sora AI that's different is now you can take a consistent character and create different scenes with the same character, which, as you know, if you've used any image generation, you can't have like a consistent character or element through multiple iterations of the same thing. Yeah. Right. You have it like starts over every time. So let's roll this one. This one will be fun, even if you're just listening, because it tells the story. And we'll tell you the visual at the end, because it'll maybe be a little surprise for you if you're just listening. But go ahead, let's roll the second one. We're looking at a man walking through the grass toward a bike right now. Can't see his head. The title is Airhead.
Something unique about them. Something that sets them apart. It's just in my case, you know, it's quite obvious what that thing is. I am literally filled with hot air. Yeah, living like this has its challenges. Windy days, for one, are particularly troublesome. Or there was the one time my girlfriend insisted I go to the cactus store to get my Uncle Jerry a wedding present.
Ugh. This man has a balloon for a head.
What do I love most about my predicament? Through the perspective it gives me, you know, I get to see the world differently. I float above the mundane and the ordinary. I see things a different way from everyone else. Yeah, and I feel like it's because of that perspective I'm reminded every day that life is fragile. We're all just a pinprick away from deflation. So I try to live life with a lightness, a buoyancy, a joie de vivre. I got a lot of ideas keeping this thing full. With any luck, I'll find a way to share them with everyone else.
So there you go. It was a man walking through life with a balloon for a head.
So good.
And that one actually was of all the five or six that we saw, that one kept me interested. And I think it's because a human wrote the story.
Yeah. It's storytelling is what holds that together so well. So, you know, I guess when I hear this type of story, when we talk about the story topic as a whole with Sora, I think of all of the name, image, and likeness that can come from this, especially the people who are concerned with ethically. And then also, can I really create a video of Paul J. Daly committing a crime and then turn that in as evidence? Like, those are the two things I think of.
No, I'm not going to believe you on that one, Jordan.
Yeah.
Well, let's tie this back down, right? Because I know, like, sometimes we you know, taking the liberty today to go a little bit deeper on something that's not specifically directly tied to the auto industry. But if you think about the implications of what this has, obviously you go marketing first, right? Content creation first. Mm-hmm. And, you know, the question on whether AI is good or bad, I think in the marketing world, it's like this gives you the opportunity to unlock a lot more potential, to unlock more people, to do more with less. And it still comes back to, can you tie human emotions? Can you tie human desires? What do we want? What do we want out of life? What makes us tick? What would make us move to or from a brand? Can you still have the creative impetus to do that in a way that helps you sell cars, service vehicles, have people take a step closer to who you are, want to work at your dealership, want to stay at your industry partner, you know, company? Like, I think it's just still going to be the Wild West, but I think that the core elements of it are still the same.
Yeah, I think it's the Wild West in a good way. People are concerned about this taking over Hollywood. That's not the case. It's going to be small creators on YouTube, on Instagram, places like that, smaller places like linear TV marketing that dealers use. It's going to be those spaces where the new creative minds can really take advantage of resources like this.
Yeah, I agree with you. Well, there you go. We gave you a few things to think about. The one thing we really want you to leave thinking about is how you are going to get to a SotoCon in May 15th and 16th. Go to asotocon.com. Check out the agenda. You won't want to miss it.
See you there.